Hey guys, how's it going? So today we are looking at a 2-in-1 convertible laptop from Lenovo. This is Lenovo Flex 14 and it comes in both Intel and AMD configuration. So which one of these two is the best value for your hard-earned dollars? Let's find out. So for under $560, you can get Lenovo Flex 14 with AMD Ryzen 5 processor. This is currently the number one best-selling 2-in-1 laptop on Amazon. For additional $200, you can get one with Core i7, the Intel Core i7 processor, and this one comes with a discrete NVIDIA GPU. So links to both these configurations are in the description below, and you can click on these links to find the latest price. The price will fluctuate, but the Intel one is about $200 more expensive than AMD. Both Intel and AMD version, they come with a full HD touchscreen display. So this is a 1920 by 1080p LED backlit IPS panel. The screen pumps out a maximum brightness of 250 nits. So this is bright enough for indoor use. If you are using this laptop indoors, whether it's classroom or office environment, even if it's a bright lit office environment or a classroom or a conference room, you should not have any problem using this laptop. But if you plan to use this laptop outdoors, say if you want to chill out in your backyard and, you know, do some internet surfing, then you will have trouble. And the reason for this is that the panel is actually a glossy panel, so it has a lot of glare and reflections. Even indoors, if you are sitting, say, in a couch with a bright window behind you, then you are going to get a lot of reflections. But one good thing is that the screen is completely touch enabled and it also comes with a stylus pencil. So Lenovo calls it an active pen. And interestingly, the AMD version of this laptop, you get the active pen for free, but for some bizarre reason, the Intel version does not, you don't get the pen for free, you have to buy it separate. Now the active pen, it's pretty useful for students and also for creative professionals. The pen is fairly accurate and it supports palm rejection. It's not as precise as the Apple Pen on iPad or the Microsoft Surface Pen that you get on the Surface Book, but it's good enough for taking notes, for sketching or doodling. Since Lenovo Flex folds 360 degrees back, the hinge reliability is very crucial. Thankfully, the hinge on this laptop is really awesome. It has a solid build quality and it should be able to handle all the stress that comes with a, you know, a hinge which has a 360 degree foldable design. The tablet mode is really great for consumption, like watching Netflix or YouTube video. Another good thing is that the battery life on this laptop is fantastic. Both Intel and AMD version will give you about 10 hours of battery life. Now, I did not get 10 hours of battery life. I got about 7 to 7.5 hours of battery life under normal usage conditions. And I think for a normal day, 7.5 hours, that's good enough. You know, you can call it an all-day battery life. Now let's talk about the internal hardware. Lenovo Flex 14, it's available in both Intel and AMD configuration. Intel configuration comes with Core i7-8550U processor. Unfortunately, this isn't the latest Intel CPU. This is actually the 8th generation Kaby Lake refresh, which was released at the end of 2017. So that's like more than 2 years old. The AMD version, on the other hand, this one is using the Ryzen 5 3500U processor. And this was released at the beginning of 2019. So this is comparatively a newer processor. Now let's compare the performance of these two CPUs. So this chart shows the performance rating from Passmark benchmarking software. First, let's look at the single thread performance. So in the single thread performance, Intel Core i7 is actually almost 17% faster than Ryzen 5. Specifically, Intel chip is scoring 2127 Passmark points versus the AMD chip, which scores 1809 points. The gap narrows in multi-threaded benchmarking, but Intel still manages to come out ahead. It's a narrow victory and it's about 5% faster than the AMD chip. Now, Intel configuration, it also comes with a faster GPU. This is actually an external GPU, whereas the AMD version is using an internal GPU. So the Intel version, it comes with NVIDIA GeForce MX130. AMD, on the other hand, it's paired with the Radeon Vega 8. So in this chart, you can see the comparative performance of both these GPUs. So in most of the synthetic benchmarks, the NVIDIA MX130, it's about 15 to 50% faster than Vega 8. But realistically speaking, both these GPUs are pretty good. You can play titles like Fortnite and PUBG on both these laptops without any issue. 4K video playback from YouTube and Netflix is smooth. There are no dropped frames and there are no stutters. Now moving on to the system RAM, both these laptop configurations, they have similar memory. So the system memory is divided into two parts. There is a 4 GB of onboard RAM that is soldered to the motherboard. The remaining RAM is installed on a solitary DIMM slot. Intel configuration comes with a total of 16 GB RAM, while the AMD version has 12 GB RAM. So that means you get only one DIMM slot for RAM upgrade. Now you can put a maximum of 16 GB RAM in this DIMM slot. So if you choose to do so, you will be able to boost the total system RAM to 20 GB. So that's the 16 GB in the slot plus your 4 GB of soldered RAM. So you can buy the compatible RAM from Amazon. I will throw a link in the description below of a compatible RAM which you can buy and max out the memory. I honestly don't like the practice of these manufacturers who solder the RAM to the motherboard. It would be perfect if they give us two DIMM slots and you can like put 16 GB memory in each slot and you know have a total of 32 GB. Unfortunately, you can't do this on this laptop. Now when it comes to storage, both these laptops have 256 GB of NVMe SSD storage. Unfortunately, there is no extra SATA 3 or M.2 slot available. So if you want to increase the storage, you will have to replace this 256 GB SSD with a bigger one. So I will throw a link in the description of a compatible M.2 SSD in the description below, and you can get that from Amazon if you are interested in increasing your storage. Okay, now let's talk about the keyboard. So both these laptops, they come with good quality keyboard. The keyboard is backlit illuminated, which is really awesome. The keyboard feels sturdy and typing experience is pleasant. The key travel is short but understandable due to the thin and light nature of this laptop. The laptop comes with a large trackpad which supports multi-finger gestures. It comes with Windows Precision drivers and supports pinch and zoom, scrolling and all other Windows 10 gestures. Both AMD and Intel version come with fingerprint sensor for passwordless login. So overall, I think Lenovo Flex 14, it's a great laptop, not only for students and creative professionals, but for anyone looking for a thin and light laptop. Now between the Intel and AMD configuration, I would highly recommend the AMD version. You will not only save $200, but you will not be sacrificing any significant performance. If you plan to game a lot on this laptop, then Intel version is a better choice because it has a discrete NVIDIA GPU. But honestly speaking, for gaming, I would recommend a gaming laptop. So check out my review of Acer Predator Helios 300, which is an excellent budget gaming laptop. I will drop a link in the description to that video review, and that would be a better laptop for you if your goal is to game. But if you want a thin and light laptop which has touch support, excellent keyboard, excellent trackpad, excellent battery life, convert it into a tablet mode, chill out on your couch, watch videos, if that's what you are looking for, then Lenovo Flex 14, I think this is a really good laptop. So that's it guys, hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions or comment, please drop it in the comment section below. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more awesome content like this. Also check out technopandareviews.com for additional reviews on laptops, gaming PCs, TVs, monitors, cameras and any other gadget. Again, thanks for watching this video and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.